Yeah, this is 20, question 24, and give your answers in radians. So we're going to do radians, inverse, and evaluate with the calculator. And we can use the Alex calculator. The key part is make sure you're in radians, because that's what they want the answers. And this one's really just plug it in. Inverse sine of 1.62. So what sine would give us 1.62? This we're going to hit this, but it should say undefined. Because you cannot get a sine that's bigger than 1 or less than negative 1. That's why it says undefined. And that's one of our possible choices. So there we go. Tangent of 0.59. So the inverse tangent. We're going to, let's clear this out. Inverse tangent of 0.59. Positive and everything, we get this value that's in radians, so it's zero, and they want it to the nearest hundredth, so 0.53. The three gets rounded down, as they say, 0.53. That's that. Cosine, we want the inverse cosine of negative 0.55, so let's clear this. Inverse tangent, negative 0.55. It equal, and that's going to give us a radian value of 2.153 or 2.15. The 3 means we don't round the 5 up, we leave it as is, and that's how we do those. Okay, but yeah, if you ever have a sine or a cosine larger than 1 or less than negative 1, you're going to get undefined. It just is not. You can't take that inverse because you can't get the sine or cosine of that.